tails first.
Yeah, that's
we're
fine.
We're riding time! I've been riding for 5 years. I started with my CBT in a 125 and now I'm on a 700 GS.
I'm Inigo. I've been riding for probably 15 years now. I started riding in Spain, but got my first big bike when I moved to the UK over 10 years ago. We came up with it at the end of 2018, I think. We had been dating for a while then, but then we started talking. She really, she always mentions how she liked people writing like food reviews and stuff like that. And she had started riding by them. And I had always had the idea of writing something around motorcycles. So I basically suggested, why don't we merge both together? And then we do like some food reviews, you know, gear, videos. And I think that's why we started the blog, the Instagram, the Facebook.
We cover quite a few miles each year as well. So the reviews and things are sort of based on quite a significant amount of riding, not just a sort of a quick ride around town.
We will do, so I will do around between 20 and 30,000 miles a year. That involves obviously UK riding, rest of Europe, and green laning as well. So I've got another bike that I use for green laning. So it's a fair amount of riding. I think you, Natalia, will do around 10 to 15,000 with me every year.
Yeah.
Roughly. So, you know.
We use the products.
Yes.
Because I said I wanted to go and see it. Then we went up to Inverness, through Loch Ness, through the National Park. Then we started
Balmoral.
Then we went up the NC500 and did bits of that. Then we came down over to Skye, Fort William, to here, to Scott Oiler, in Glasgow. We're crossing over to St Andrews and then we're coming back down home.
Yeah. It's been a trip that I think Scotland was pending for quite a while. She studied in St Andrews University, and when we came to her graduation, we came on the bikes. But it was a bit of a bad experience. one of the fork seals on the bike went. We had to stop the trip halfway, cold recovery in York.
Yeah.
It was a bit interesting. So this trip has been long overdue now. And interestingly, we came here because her passport didn't come back, so we couldn't go into Europe.
We're meant
to be in
Germany.
But here we are.
Fair exchange.
Yeah, we're not planning to come to Scotland in October. I mean, it's been raining every day. Yeah.
There's been sun every day as well.
There's been sun every day as well.
Like about 20 minutes of sun, that's probably about
roughly.
Ratio's changed.
Yes.
The Alps.
When did you go there?
We went then
2019 for 2 weeks. We went to the BMW
days in Garmisch-Partenkirchen.
I would officially live in Garmisch since being there. Yeah. And then we came back down through Italy and Dolomites and back to France and crossed over again. I think for me it was the landscape and just the roads, they're phenomenal. That's what I liked most about it. And we were actually reminiscing about that trip whilst we were riding around Scotland,
yeah.
And we definitely want to do it.
How some parts of Scotland are really close to the Alps, but obviously much lower, so things are, you know. The only thing we found is Scotland is beautiful if you can see outside, which is a challenge. But the impressive thing about the Alps and what we like about the trip as well, the road trip is slightly more challenging, as in more technical, all the mountain passes, so it adds the scenery that you've got with all that technicality as well, and the challenge of the height, which makes a huge difference when you're riding as well.
Yeah.
Not only to the bike technically, but to you.
Having said that, I got altitude sickness.
Oh, really?
Yeah, no. Which was quite shocking because I've never experienced that. And I was like, I'm actually exhausted. And then you'd go down like 100 meters, like, oh, I feel fine.
That's nuts.
On our bucket list, Spain and Portugal. So go down to Portugal and back up. So we haven't done Portugal before. Iceland.
Iceland is probably maybe a 2 years time thing. But is there
And the Pyrenees
section. And the Pyrenees and the Alps probably. So we do a lot of long weekends. So, you know, we'll go to Wales, to the Yorkshire Dales, to the Peak District, Lake District, down to Devon, Cornwall, doing a lot of long weekends. But obviously when we go outside that comfort zone, we like to take at least 9 days. And obviously we are not full-time motorcyclists, like we are full-time something else. And that's what takes most of our time. So Monday to Friday, we are working, we got on the bikes, we've got one dog. So it means that, you know, we cannot always both go on the bike for the whole day. Someone has to take care of the dog. So there are limitations. So we try to do this while we do other things. So. Instagram. I think Instagram is the main place. The website as well. The website has a bit of information. It is ridingtime.com. The website is fading down a bit as well. We don't see as many traffic, and it seems that people are moving more into the social media, fast acting social media. So we are trying to do a bit of a twist with what we do. So this year we've done something that is called the Riding Time UK Challenge. So it's based in something that ABR magazine did at the beginning, I think it was December or November last year. They presented a set of 12 routes in the UK, one for each month of the year. So we took the idea and we shaped that into something similar, but with a bit of our personal touch. And we've done one ride each month of the year. Open to anyone to join, so the information is at the website, social media. We went to Snowdonian in January. There were 10 people waiting for me to go on to Snowdonian in January. I was like, yeah. Amazed about that. In March, 18 people came and joined from the middle of Wales. And it's something we are trying to develop it a bit more. And maybe next year, you know, continue doing it, but we have to think about how we do it. But we're going to the Peak District this last week of the month, so 29th and 30th. Again, people book their own hotel. Anyone joins, we just run it as a soul thing. It's really good. We've got a massive group of people now that, you know, keep meeting each other when they want to go on rides and stuff like that. So we want to try to develop a bit more. It's more about when we go on the bike, it's about meeting people. It's about talking to people. And it's about that, isn't it?
Yeah.
I think the highlight of the Alps was meeting two guys in a farm that we end up going for a meals with their family the rest of the days in Garmisch. And we met them and we've gone back to Munich to meet them. We hosted a couple of guys that were traveling from Switzerland to Iceland to Cape Town. They live in Switzerland, and it's about that biking community. It's about meeting people. It's not about the machine itself. It's about what you can do with the bike that we enjoy.
That's excellent. Unreal. Well, thanks very much, Fingers.
That's all right.